Вернее, дисциплина для Америки будет посистем, для людей, для бритчей будет посистем, для бритчей будет посистем. We can say that that there is a concept or idea of so-called majoritarian democracy. Majoritarian democracy. It means the type of the political system in which majority prevails. Majority prevails. Political party goes to the elections, or the coalition of the political parties goes to the elections. They get the majority of votes in the elections. They transfer this majority to seats, and they create the parliamentary majority. And as a result of that one, they create the government. So this type of the political system are known as majority democracy. Majority, you need 51%. You need 51% of votes, 51% of seats in the parliamentary assembly, and you can lead, you can govern the country. So it is the characteristic of, or it is the characteristic of most of the European countries today, most of the Western countries today. And this type of democracy, or this type of political system prevails in those countries where the political culture is homogeneous. Political culture is homogeneous. It means the society consists of one ethnic group, one religious group, one linguistic group, one racial group. They more or less, the whole people in the society, they subscribe to the same political culture, and as a result of this one, we have the political elites who practice the same common values, common beliefs, common norms, etc. And that is the case with the homogeneous societies. But how can we, yes, and the goal of each political system, the goal of each political system is to bring stability and development, to bring stability and development in the society. The main goal, the main target of each political system is to achieve these two things, political stability and economic development. And in homogeneous societies, it may say that they use majority democracy. But what is the case with heterogeneous societies? What is the case with Bosnia? How to bring this political stability and how to bring economic development? What is the method, what is the approach, what is the way, how to achieve it? In addition to this majority democracy in political science, in comparative politics, there is a concept called power sharing approach. Power sharing approach. And here is mainly what is meant is the executive power. Power or executive authority. And this power sharing approach prevails in heterogeneous societies. In heterogeneous societies. Society which is composed of two or more groups, two or more segments. Power sharing approach. One of the examples of power sharing approach and this model and this approach is used in Bosnia is the model which is called consociational democracy. One of the models of this power sharing approach is called consociational democracy.
Consociational. One of the what?
Of the models, or of the way of power sharing approach. One of the ways, one of the models of power sharing approach is called consociational democracy. The model of consociational democracy was introduced by a gentleman called Arend Liebhardt. Arend Liebhardt was a guy, political scientist, who introduced this model in late 1970s. And he introduced this concept in terms of explaining political development and political stability and economic development in the case of Poland from 1970 until 1967.
Poland.
Yes, Poland, Netherlands.
Yeah.
Introduced and then political stability and economic development in Poland and Netherlands for the period from 1917 until 1967. During this time, Poland was a country, state characterized by heterogeneous society, state composed of many segments, but still Poland was able to bring the institutions of the state of Poland were able to produce and to bring this political stability and economic development. And I think that he tried to explain this one applying or introducing the model of association. The main thesis, or the main premise, and remember this one, the main statement of association democracy is, in a heterogeneous society, you can write down this, in a heterogeneous society, cooperative behavior among elected political elites is positively related to political stability. Okay, I repeat. In a heterogeneous society, in a segmented society, in a plural society, cooperative behavior among elected political elites is positively related to political stability and economic growth. We have two main variables. In a segmented society, in a plural society, cooperative behavior, cooperation, or cooperative behavior among elected political elites who are elected in the elections and who represent the people in the legislative branch of the government, in the executive branch of the government. Cooperative behavior among these elected political elites is positively related to political stability and economic development of that particular country. So here we have two main variables. The first variable is cooperative behavior among elected political elites, and the second variable, dependent variable, is political stability and economic development. So we can draw that, we can present that first in terms of graph. So here, behavior of political elites. So what it looks like this. So this is the model of associational democracy.
Does it work?
We will see.
It is working.
We will see it worked.
Really?
Yes, we will see what does work and under what conditions it works. So the model consists of the behavior of political plates. These are the elements of the model: grand coalition, mutual veto, proportional representation, and segmental autonomy. And this is the result. And for this one to be achieved, some conditions have to be fulfilled. So there are conditions
to what?
Yes, for the political elites to cooperate, to have cooperative behavior. If these conditions are fulfilled, then it will lead to cooperation among political elites through grand coalition, mutual veto, proportional representation, segmental autonomy, and as a result of this, there is a political stability and economic development. Segmental autonomy, yes. On the other hand, if there is a confrontation, if there is a lack of cooperation among elected political elites, then definitely it will lead to instability and economic underdevelopment or economic decay. The lack of economic development. So the emphasis is on this. The emphasis is on cooperative behavior. Cooperative behavior among elected political elites for the sake of achieving political stability and economic development. And we will see now that when we apply this model to the Bosnian political system, we will see that the whole Bosnian political system is supposed to be based on this model. So what we studied, it is here. The whole structure is in this world. So the first character we said that the main hypothesis, the main basis is the cooperation in a heterogeneous society. Cooperation among elected political elites is positively related to political stability. So more cooperation, more stability. Less cooperation, more instability. Stability is political stability. Stability in the state institutions. Stability in the state institutions, in the government or in the parliament. So the first characteristic or the first feature of the constitutional model of democracy is grand coalition. Grand coalition here means coalition of political parties, of the political parties that represent main segments of the society. So coalition of political parties that represent main segments of the society. So each segment in the society is represented, ideally it would be is represented by one political party. And these political parties that represent segments in the society, they come to the coalition. They make coalition. And here we can distinguish between two types of coalitions. The first one is pre-election, and the second one is post-election coalition. Pre-election coalition and post-election coalition. Pre-election coalition is much better for the sake of political stability and economic development. It is much better in a way that usually in the case of pre-election coalition, Different political parties are coming with the common program, and the goal of this coalition is to implement that program for the sake of political stability and economic development. So in the case of pre-election coalition of the main political parties, they have a common program, they have the common goals, common objectives, and their goal is to achieve these objectives. In the case of post-election coalition, usually this type of coalition is a mathematical coalition. It is a simply mathematical coalition, or coalition for the sake of achieving the parliamentary majority. And in the case of post-election coalition, usually political parties, they don't have
they don't have
common program.
They don't if have they common have common program and if they have at the same time mathematical issue.
No. This time, to have this pre-election coalition, to have program, you must have mathematical coalition. This mathematical coalition must exist for the sake of achieving a majority in the parliament. But in the first case, before you make this mathematical coalition, you have a program. So, for example, you have so many political parties here. Okay? And in the case of pre-election coalition, for example, you choose these four political parties, they are coming together, they create a program, and they say after the elections we are going to achieve the majority to implement this one. They have the common program. And at the same time, after the elections, they have majority in the parliament. In the case of post-election coalition, for example, these political parties, they participated in the elections and they said, okay, this political party, this one, and this one, we can create a majority. Because we have the majority of the votes, we have the majority of the seats, let us create the majority for the sake of establishing the government. But we don't have any program. We are coming to the power, we are coming to make this coalition only for the sake of establishing the government. But we don't have the common program. We don't have the common goals. So that is the main case in Bosnia. In Bosnia, we have in the Bosnian political system, we have mathematical coalitions, post-election coalitions.
Post-election.
You can call it anyway, you can use any name. But the coalition is made simply for the sake of having the majority in the parliament. So, for example, what was the case after the elections 1996 in this country? These two so-called nationalistic political parties that they were fighting against each other during the war. After the elections 1996, they made a mathematical coalition only for the sake of establishing the government. But they had nothing in common. They had nothing in common. There was no common goal for them.
Also, in Turkey, in the past, Democratic Left Party and National Movement Party, they made a coalition together.
Yeah, only for the sake of majority, nothing else. That there is a government. How the government is going to function, it is a matter of...
Establishing government, yes, in this case.
Yes. You make a majority in the parliamentary assembly for the sake of establishing the government. So that is the first characteristic, that is the first feature of the Grand Coalition. That is the first characteristic of the constitutional model for the democracy. The second characteristic or the second feature is mutuality. Mutual veto. Mutual veto means that each segment in the society, each part of the society must have constitutional right to veto any decision which they consider is against the interest of the people whom they represent. Each segment of the society must have constitutional right to stop, to veto any decision which they consider is against the interest of their own people. So, for example, here we saw it, for example, in the House of Peoples, or even in the House of what we saw it, for example, yes, entity war. In the case of Bosnia, there is an entity war. Or in the parliamentary assembly, in the House of Representatives, or in the House of Peoples, or a better example is the collective presidency. Collective presidency, which consists of three representatives, each one of them has veto power. Each member of the collective presidency has a veto power. Or when it comes to the House of Peoples at the state level, those five representatives who represent one segment of the society, they have the veto. So, Grand Coalition is the first, the second one is, of course, this mutual veto, which is constitutional. For example, in most of the cases in Bosnia, it is misused and abused. They don't veto certain decisions, certain laws, certain rules and regulations because it is against their own people. We saw it, they mainly veto these rules, these decisions, because Implementing or passing these decisions at the state level means that you are going to reduce the power of the entity. So they don't veto that because it is against the interest of the people. They veto that one simply because it means that you are going to transfer some of the power from the state, from the entity level, and you are going to move that one to the state level. So that's why they use this, they use the veto power.
Fortunately, we don't have it.
Sorry?
Fortunately, we don't have this because the other would be always against. In Turkey.
Yeah, but in Turkey, for example, you had this during there was a veto power used by the president, Ahmet Necip, when he was using his constitutional power as a president not to sign certain laws that were passed in the parliament. The next characteristic or the next feature of the constitutional democracy is proportional representation. Proportional representation. Proportional representation now means that each segment of the society has to be proportionally represented in three branches of the government, in the legislative, executive, judiciary, and bureaucracy. So, for example, in the distribution of the, if it's like this, let's say, 40%, if one segment of the society makes 40% of the population and other two, 30% it means this certain segment of the society would be this segment of the society would be represented to this extent in the legislative, executive, and judiciary branch of the government. So representation will be representation in the state institutions will be proportional to the population in the society. In this case, there is, and we mentioned that there is something what is called positive discrimination. In this context, or in this case, when it comes to proportional representation, there is something called positive discrimination. When one segment of the society, when all the segments of the society are equally represented in the state institutions, and it is called parity representation. Parity representation. Parity. Parity representation. And again here, for example, we can, in the case of Bosnia, we can give example of the collective presidency. For example, Croats, according to the last census, Croats, they made only 80% of the population, but they have one representative in the collective presidency, same like Bosniaks, who had 43% of the...
Same with the House of People.
Yes, same with the House of People at the state level, same with the House of People at the federal level. So there is this equal representation of all segments of the society, irrespective of their part or of their share in the society, then it is based on the principle of party representation, and it's called in political science, it's called positive discrimination. So we can say to some extent the associational model of democracy supports this idea, promotes this idea of positive discrimination. And the last one is segmental autonomy. It means that each part of the society enjoys certain level of autonomy, not independence, autonomy, in some parts of the country. Certain level of autonomy in some parts of the country when it comes to the decision-making process. So, for example, in the case of Bosnia, we saw that in the federation, the federation is divided into cantons, into 10 cantons. In some of them, Bosniaks make majority, some of them Croats make majority. So, in those cantons in which Croats make majority, they have some sort of autonomy when it comes to the decision-making process. Or, for example, in the case of Republika Srpska, it is mostly populated by Serbs, and they enjoy some sort of autonomy when it comes to the decision-making process and law-making procedure. So it is called segmental autonomy. So these are the main characteristics, these are the main features of association of modern democracy. For this one to be achieved, some of the conditions must be fulfilled. So now make distinction between the characteristics of the consociationalism, these are the characteristics, and the conditions which are supposed to be fulfilled to bring this. So the first condition for this model of democracy to be successful is multiple balance of power. The first characteristic or the first feature is multiple balance of power.
First condition.
First condition is multiple balance of power. It means that no majority exists in the society. So, meaning that no segment of the society makes 50% of the population. No segment of the society makes 50% of the population. Because if one segment of the society makes 50% of the population, then that segment of the society can prevail, can dominate other segments of the society. So the first condition is that no majority segment exists in the society. The second characteristic or the second feature is that these segments that exist in the society should be more or less of equal size of the segments that exist in the society. So for example, ideally it would be like this, that each segment of the society, but of course it is impossible to find this one, but what would be close to ideally is that these segments are more or less equal in terms of size. So for example, like this. As I said, it is impossible to find that idea that the same segments of the society or more equal size, but more closer these segments in terms of the size, it is better for the success of the constitutional model of democracy. The next condition is the size number. So the first one is that there is no majority of the segment, the second one is the equal size, and the second one is the number of these segments. They say that the best or ideal distribution of the society in the segments would be between 3 to 5. The best distribution of the society in terms of segments will be between 3 to 5. If it is less than 3, it means if you have 2, then definitely one of them will be majority. So the minimum is 3, and it can go beyond 5, but they say if it goes beyond 5, then usually it creates fragmented political structure. The society is so much fragmented. And it means what we said just now, if you have 7 segments of the society, it means that for each segment of the society there is one political party representing the society, and when you make this grand coalition, it means that in this grand coalition you have to include 7 political parties. When you have more political parties, more political elites, then it is much more difficult to make consensus. Much more difficult to make decisions in the state institutions. So they said the ideal is between three to five. So for example, when it comes to Bosnia, to the case of Bosnia, all these 3 conditions are okay, are acceptable. Because they have multiple balance of power, There is no one segment of the society which makes majority. More or less, we are equal in terms of size, except tribes, who make around, now they make between 10 to 15% of the population. And size number, yes, we have three segments of the society, and all these are conducive conditions for the constitution of modern democracy to function. The next condition for the success of, or for the functioning of the constitutional model of democracy is segmental isolation. So here it was segmental autonomy, so don't mix segmental autonomy with segmental isolation.
Is it fourth, right?
Yes. Segmental isolation. This means that there will be more chance for constitutional democracy to succeed if the segments of the society, or the groups in the society, parts of the society, are isolated from each other. They don't live together. So, for example, if this is the country, let's say, and it's composed of three segments. So segment X here, Y here, and Z here. So it would be better if they don't mix with each other. For example, they related this one to, there is a, there is a saying in English, good friends make good neighbors. In Bosnian language, dobra ograda čini dobre komšije, pravi dobre komšije. So good friends make good neighbors. So if there is a good friends here, in Turkish, you understand this?
Yes, of course.
So if there is a good friends, if there is a good barrier here, between or among the segments of the society, then there is a higher chance, there is a bigger chance that the neighbors will be better in terms of cooperation. But here they said that why it is okay, why this one is accepted, because mainly the emphasis, and then we will see one of the critiques of the constitution of the model of democracy, the emphasis here is on political elites. In this constitutional model of democracy, the emphasis, the importance goes to political elites. It does not go to the society. So to some extent, we can say that the society is neglected. People are neglected.
So this XYZ is talking about elites?
No, about segments of the society.
Okay.
And of course, we have elites coming from these segments. But these are the main segments of the society.
Okay.
So they said this one, if the segments of the society are isolated, if they don't live together, then there is a less possibility for conflict and confrontation among them. So that will be one of the features, one of the characteristics, or one of the conditions, sorry, for the association of democracy to succeed. The next feature, or the next condition, is tradition. Tradition of elite accommodation. Tradition of elite accommodation. It means that there is a bigger chance for this model of democracy to succeed if the political elites who represent these segments of the society, they had some experience with democracy in the past. So that is that there will be more chance for this model of democracy, constitutional democracy, to succeed if the political elites who represent these segments of these parts of the society, if they had some tradition, if they had some experience with the democracy in terms of making compromise, in terms of making consensus, etc. So that's why they said this condition is not fulfilled in the case of Bosnia, because Bosnia, before it became independent, was part of Yugoslavia. And Yugoslavia was a social state. There was no democracy. There was only one political party. And the current political elites or the political elites that have been living in this country, they didn't have this tradition of accommodation. They didn't have this tradition, this experience of making compromise with others.
But it's also some reconciliation is not really some places are, but
of
most of the places are quite mixed.
Yeah, for example, we will see the, when it comes to the critiques of this model of democracy, it is impossible to find all these conditions in ideal form. It is always partially fulfilled, partially implemented. And for example, yes, segmental isolation, but again, as we said, segmental isolation, what we said just now, the Republika Srpska is most populated by Serbs, and some cantons are most populated by Bošnjaks, and some cantons are mostly populated by Croats. So to some extent, that can be considered as segmental isolation. So tradition of elite accommodation is another condition for the success of associational model of democracy. The next condition is the nature of and the cleavages might be of two types. The cleavages might be of two types. They can be mutually exclusive or cross-cutting. Cleavages might be mutually exclusive and they might be cross-cutting cleavages. Cross-cutting cleavages are mainly politico-economic cleavages and mutually exclusive cleavages are identity cleavages. Cross-cutting cleavages are basically politico-economic cleavages and mutually exclusive are cleavages based on the identity. And I said that this type of cleavages, cross-cutting cleavages, are much more conducive, are much better for the success of associational model democracy. This means political-economic cleavages are type of the cleavages and the differences or the characteristics of the society that you can change. For example, you can change the political party that you support. You can change, for example, NGO that you are a member of. When it comes to economy, for example, today you can change your economic status. Today you belong to the lower status in the society, and tomorrow you can belong to the upper status of the society. So these cross-cutting cleavages are more conducive for the success of this one, because people, they can move from one to another. When it comes to this one, to mutually exclusive cleavages, which are based on identity, it is very difficult for people to change. So for example, it is very difficult for you to change religion. Religion is an example of mutually exclusive cleavage. Or for example, ethnicity. Or race. These are the type of cleavages which are mutually exclusive. Very difficult to change. And as a result of this one, if the society is characterized by this type of cleavages, then there is a less possibility for the constitution of democracy to succeed. So the nature of social cleavages will define to what extent there will be cooperation among the political elites, and to what extent it is going to produce political stability with the economic element. So basically, these are the conditions for the. Yes, another condition for the success of this one is the duration of to what extent consociational democracy has been practiced in the society. So duration of practicing consociational model of democracy in the society and in the state institutions. Duration. Duration of practicing or exercising consociational model. So if it is being more exercised, if it is being more practiced in the society, then there is a higher probability that it will succeed. If the duration is shorter, then the possibility for the success of consociational model of democracy is low. So make a distinction between the conditions and the characteristics of the
association of modern movements.
Is it clear?
Yes.
Yeah.
What are the critiques? What are the critiques?
We don't have time for
it. What is the time?
Lami, yeah, fine.
We can finish. Critiques. One basic critique on this one is the emphasis is on this one. The emphasis is on political ethics, and society is neglected. This model of democracy does not talk too much about the society. This model of democracy mainly discusses the issue of the behavior of political ethics. The next critique of this model of democracy is that the basic concepts which are used here, and that is the heterogeneous society and the model itself, are not precisely defined. There is no precise definition of what is plural society, what is segmented society, what is the meaning of divided society. And there is no precise definition of what is grand coalition. All these concepts which are used by this gentleman, by this guy who introduced this one, there is no precise, there is no concrete, there is no measurable definition of these concepts. There is no measurable definition of these concepts. So that's why those people who criticized him, they said two things. First, he introduced these concepts without conducting an empirical study, and secondly, as a result of this one, based on these concepts which he introduced, it is not possible to conduct an empirical study in the future. So the concepts, these terms, were introduced to him without an empirical study. And as a result of this one, in the future, it is not possible to conduct an empirical study using these concepts. The next critique of this consociational model of democracy is on this one, on the behavior or cooperative behavior of political elites. They said, to what extent, for example, such a case in Bosnia, where 45% of the Bosniak, they make 45% of the society. To what extent political elites that represent this segment of the society will be ready to have cooperative behavior with other political elites in terms of making compromise.
To what extent political elites
that represent one segment of the society, which is the biggest in the society, will be ready to make compromise with other segments of the society. If you make majority of the society, if you represent the biggest size or the biggest part of the society, then you will always prefer majority democracy.
Make compromise.
Yes. Then to what extent the political elite, the biggest part of the society, will be ready to make compromise, to make consensus with other with other segments of the society. With political elites, it presents other segments of the society. Or another critique of this model of democracy is that just now we said that the model of democracy was introduced by Arend Lippert, that he introduced this model studying leaders. Those people who criticized him, they said from 1917 until 1967, although Nederland was heterogeneous society, but it was not so much politically divided in terms of political culture as it was represented by Arend Lippert himself. So the political culture was not so heterogeneous, was not so divided. It was divided, but not to the extent that it was represented, but it was presented by the guy who introduced this model of democracy. Or the next critique, and this critique is related, for example, to Boston political system, is that the emphasis of this model is so much on elections. The emphasis is so much on elections. But elections are only one segment, only one part of democracy. We cannot draw the line. We cannot draw the line of equality between democracy and elections. But this model of democracy, constitutional model of democracy, emphasizes so much on the elections. So basically, this is the model itself, which can explain the structure and the functioning of the Bosnian political system. Yes, for example, this model of democracy today is used in Belgium, in Switzerland, in Lebanon, in South Africa, in India. It is used in Malaysia. It is used in so many countries. Yes. So basically, the conditions, characteristics, and the behavior of political elites, what is said of political stability and economic development. Yes, one of the conditions that we didn't mention, it refers to the size of the country in terms of population. Size of the country in terms of population and in terms of space. Okay. This model of democracy will be more successful, there is a more chance for this model of democracy to succeed in a countries with smaller population. But population is not so big, population is not so high, then there is a big chance for this model of democracy to be successful. And at the same time, if the area of the country is smaller, then there is a higher chance for this model of democracy to be successful. Any questions?